It's good. Felt like fast 204, but time doesn't matter, so.
How
much pressure is it on you when you see how fast that first heat goes and know that only the winner in your heat's going to qualify?
I mean, I was expecting that because I said yesterday, I said, how's you going to take your heat into flat? I mean, I could have made money off that if I bet on it. And then we saw a second heat, and we had to run under, 2:02.3 for time qualifiers, and I kind of thought our heat was going to go for it because I could easily get the top four under 2:02, you know? And then it ended up being so slow and plays into my hands, so I can't complain. Just turned into a tactical affair, and us two up front had the advantage at that point when it got slow, so.
How much of a sense of relief did you have?
I wasn't going to be relieved until I crossed the line. You know, anything can happen. I was kind of watching the board at the end, and I don't normally do that. But I need to protect my space. I mean, you saw me moving out because I saw that girl moving out, and I was like playing a video game. I was like, it's just. So I crossed the line. Just feels good because, you know, 300 in, I was like, you gotta win. So.
Would that heat have gone any better?
Not for me. I just said, I hate to call anyone perfect, but I executed my plan perfectly. So I really wouldn't have done anything differently.
You talk about when you crossed the line, you gave that fist pump. I'm sure the crowd was really big behind you.
I mean, I don't think I've ever really celebrated in my life, but obviously that tells you how much that means to me. I wanted to have a good showing in my first world champ, so I didn't want to just make the team, you know, be one and done. So it's exciting because now I get the opportunity to mix it up and see what I can do at one of the high stages, so it's going to be fun.
You looked a lot better today than you did your race.